before you start threading, it's really important to make sure that your presser foot lever is up and you've lifted your foot up. This disengages your tensions and allows you to thread more easily. We're gonna start off with the 4-thread overlock. It's one of the most commonly used stitches on the serger, and it's really easy with your imagine. So let's get started. We're gonna use your quick reference threading guide, and this is really easy to understand. It's all color coded. You'll have your two needles in, your right and your left. The suggested length is 2.5 to 3.5. Your suggested width is 6 to 7.5. And your stitch selector should be at A. So let's just kind of double check that. Our differential feed is set at N. We have our stitch selector at A. And then the width is recommended at 6 to 7.5. And then our stitch length is at 2.5. We can thread in whatever order we'd like, so we are going to start right to left. We'll need to floss the guide back there. Go on down, catch the hook right there. Okay, at this point, you might notice that your looper tubes aren't engaged, and we need to go ahead and do that. So let's press that button. And then you're gonna turn your hand wheel towards you slowly until the machine locks in place. You'll hear it click, so just keep going until those loopers close. So that engages our loopers so that there's one continuous tube to where the air can blow it through all the way. Make sure that your looper selector is over at L for lower looper. And you'll want to pull out a good amount of thread, so you can pull it out to touch your knee, you can pull out 18 to 20 inches around there, but you need enough thread for it to shoot through the looper tube. Okay, so we're gonna put it in the port here. This is for your lower looper. Go ahead and press the pump, and you'll notice it shoots all the way through. Okay, so we're gonna take that thread, pass it through to the back. Now let's do your upper looper. I'm gonna come up through the thread guide, snap it in the thread guide back here, catch the hook here, and then again, pull a good amount of thread out. Place about an inch into the port. And this is important, you'll want to switch this over to you, to the upper looper. If you're pressing the pump and it's not shooting through, that's the first thing you'll want to check to make sure that you have it set to the right looper tube. Okay, and again, we're going to press the pump, and you'll see it shoot out over here. Okay, and now we'll bring the thread to the back. All right, let's go ahead and thread our needles. First, you'll want to switch this over to disengage your loopers. This is kind of neat. You can see where the thread had gone through. Turn your hand wheel. You've probably been wondering what those green marks are. You want to make sure that those green marks line up with each other. I'm just going to peek over here to make sure that they're lined up. And that way we can use your needle threader. Okay, that's the height required to use this. So let's go ahead and start with your right thread, with your right needle. Again, run it through your thread guide. Click it into place, catch the hook right here. There's another hook here. And we're gonna run up and around, much like a sewing machine. Catch the hook above your needles. Before we thread our right needle, let's go ahead and thread our left needle and thread both of them right next to each other, okay? So we're going to come up again through the thread guides, click it into place, catch the hook here. And then here, run it up and around and catch the hook up here. Okay, at this point, you'll want to put your foot down. And that will hold your threads in place so that you can better thread your machine. Okay, let's make sure that your needle threader, we're gonna start with your right needle, so you need to make sure that it's selected over to the right. Okay, do you see how this switches back and forth? We need it to be over to the right. To use the needle threader, we're going to use the middle finger of our left hand to push the needle threader down, and there's going to be a tiny hook that goes through the eye of the needle. You'll use your pointer finger of your left hand to hook the thread and touch the face of the needle. Okay, so I have hooked it here. This takes a little bit of practice, but once you get it, it's really easy. Okay, and once you pull the thread back, you can tell that it's hooked. But this takes a little bit of hand-eye coordination because as you're releasing your left hand, you want to make sure to also release the right hand, the thread that's in your right hand, so that you're not playing tug of war with your needle threader. Okay, and if it kind of gets stuck there, all you have to do is just gently lift your lever up, okay? And at this point, we'll want to unhook the thread. I'm gonna use tweezers here so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so we've unhooked it. And we're going to pull that thread to the back and underneath the foot. All right, so let's go ahead and repeat that with the left thread. We're going to switch the needle selector, the needle threader selector over to L for left. Use your middle finger of your left hand. Hook your thread, straddle it by the hook. I got a little bit too much thread there, so I'm trying to keep my fingers out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, you can tell there's tension there, so it's pulling on the hook. And release with the thread with your right hand as you're releasing with your left hand. And again, you'll just unhook your thread and pull it to the back and underneath the foot. Okay, your machine is threaded and we kind of have some excess of thread. Our foot is down, so there's tension on our thread. And all you have to do is just run those threads through your cutter and it trims them up really nicely. One last thing you'll want to check. With the Imagine, when you're using the pump here, oftentimes it's easy to accidentally hit the differential feed. So if you're not intending the differential feed to be gathering or stretching, you'll want to make sure that it's still set on in because that's what we want for our basic four thread overcast stitch, okay? So grab two pieces of fabric. We'll put pretty sides together as if we're stitching a seam and we're gonna run it through the machine. One thing I want to point out to you is that your feed dogs extend further forward than your foot, okay? So that means we don't have to necessarily lift our foot up to put our fabric underneath. You can actually just place your fabric up to the foot and we're going to line it up over because we want to see how the blade cuts, right? So the fabric's going to feed through a little bit quickly. You want to make sure that you don't play tug of war with your machine. So we're just going to go ahead and press the foot pedal down there. It's much like a gas pedal with a car. You can control your speed. Okay, and you can see that it just started pulling the fabric through, as well as cutting your fabric off right over here. We're going to leave a thread tail and you'll cut your threads right here. Look how pretty that stitch is. Let me get you acquainted with what we're looking at here. You'll see two stitch lines, straight stitch lines here. Okay, this is your left needle and this is your right needle. The zigzaggedy thread here is your upper looper thread. And you flip it to the back, and that's your lower looper thread. This can also be used as a seam, this will prevent your fabric from fraying. And if you'll open it up, you'll notice how strong it is. So it's nice to sew and serge at the same time.